Hi there, welcome to this video. Let's see together how to use Cinema 4D Release 15 in a short time. Check the quick index for the list of what is explained here. Don't forget to comment us if you notice mistakes. Before going on, let's solve a problem that might appear to you. Whatever you create, it can happen to have the preview always white or black. In case this happens, go to Edit and then to Preferences. Then into OpenGL section, untick Use OpenGL. This will solve the problem. Let's see how is the workspace. On top you have the menu bar with the full list of options this software has. A little below and on the left, you have some buttons for different purposes, from visualization to editing. On the center you have the view panel, used to get a preview of your work and edit inside. At the bottom you have some other windows, like the timeline and the material list. On the right you have panels that list objects made and their properties. Their placement can be fully customized and can be closed and opened again. To open a window closed, simply go to Windows section and choose the one interested. Let's add an object. There are three kinds of objects: 3D, 2D and path ones. You usually start from a basic model and then you personalize your object giving the shape you want. 3D and 2D objects can be created using the first two buttons in the fifth list on top. These do have a black corner, indicating a sublist inside. Simply hold your click on it and then choose the tool. All light blue buttons do create a 3D or a 2D object with the same shape indicated through the related icon button and added on the center of your project by default. Then you have the paths. These are 2D objects indeed, but they are not created with a fixed template, but can be drawn from the start. These are indicated through icons with a black and orange pencil on them. Each of these ones draws in a different way. Click on to create a new point. Click and drag to create curves if possible. If you finish your shape, press Escape. You won't exit from the tool, but indeed you end the creation of your current path. Remember that you can undo any mistaken action pressing Ctrl and Z, otherwise use the first button on top. The second one is the Redo button. Through the View panel, you can get a general preview of your project. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Hold down and click inside to change the point of view. Otherwise, simply hold your click on one of the icons in the top right corner of the view panel. The white cross on the center represents the target, so where the camera is pointing at. Otherwise, you can go to Camera section and use all the buttons from perspective to bottom. For example, to watch the project from up to down, in front or behind it. In other cases, you may need to change the way to see the objects physically, using Display section. In some cases, you need to watch the objects solid as they are, to check illumination or shadows, or simply a wireframe to lose excessive processing that may slow your PC down. Let's go on. After creating an object, this will appear in the Objects panel. This lists all the objects you have created in your project. Any kind of object is recognized through an icon, the name close to it, and several icons more on the right. The name colored in orange is the object selected at the moment. You can click on an object's name to select it. If you press Ctrl and X, you will cut the object. You can use it to delete it fast. You have several icons. The left one indicates the color of the layer it belongs to, if it does. If there is a diagonal line, it doesn't. We won't see the layers in this video. Then you have two rounded buttons. The upper one indicates the object in the view panel, the downer one the object in the rendered view. So if the button is green, the object is visible, if red is invisible. If gray, the visualization is managed auto. Simply click on them to set the status. The third icon sets the visibility of the object regardless of the view or the rendered case. Hide objects in case you have too many of them on your site while working. Each object has its own properties, shown in the attributes panel, right below the panel seen before. This lists all the properties of the object selected. In Basic, you change the object name, the layer it has to belong to, add any color, or make the object transparent through X-ray. You have other options here that you can use when you are more expert. To edit an object, you need to have it selected. There are different ways to select an object. You can click on its name in the objects panel, or you can use the selection tools, all inside the first icon of the second group of tools above. If you want to use these, I advise you to enable the second button you have on the left, to make selections easier. Through Live Section, you just need to click on the objects on the preview to select them. If you hold the Shift down, you can select more objects together. Rectangle Selection selects all objects that fall inside the rectangle area you create by clicking and dragging on. Lasso Selection is freehand, and Polygon Selection creates the selection area, fixing points one by one. With the Model mode on and the object selected, you can edit the object fast. Click on one of the three colored arrows and drag to move the object on the same direction indicated by the selected arrow. Each one is a Cartesian axis. The green one is the Z axis, indicating the height. The red and the blue ones are the X and the Y axes to move the object without changing the height. You can move using also the symbols with the same blue, green and red colors. For example, if you use the green one, you move the object without changing values on the green direction, so without changing the height. Moreover, you can scale the object. To do this, you need to drag the small orange points. They can be 3, 2, depending on the shape of the object. The scaling will be made across the axis direction where the orange point lays. You may need to use the scale tool to keep constant the aspect ratio, or scale to the objects. The arrows will end up with cubes that you can drag to scale. Enable the Rotate tool to rotate the object. To be precise, it's better to use just the colored circumferences. Simply click and drag on them. Cinema will indicate you how many degrees. You can hold Shift down to use just multiples of 10 degrees. Mind that, if you rotate the object, object and world coordinates won't be identical anymore. Click on the Coordinates button above to choose which is the system to follow. To be very precise in your editings, you can use the coordinates panel or the chord section in the attributes panel. Simply digit the correct value. P stays for position, S for scale, and R for rotation. Mind that any value without a measurement unit is a ratio. 1 means 100%, so the original value of the object. We can modify the shape of the object as well, in two ways. You can create new objects using the existing one. All these tools are in green color. For example, let's transform a 2D object into a 3D one. In the third icon of the last group of tools, search for Extrude. This will add a new object in your list. These objects can be visible or invisible, depending on what is the proper action of the tool. In this case, the Extrude object is nothing on the preview. However, if you click and release a 2D object on the Extrude name, this will later become in 3D. The union of the Extrude object and the 2D one makes a 3D object with the shape of the basic 2D one. This values as long as the object is inside it. You can then click and drag the object outside to have it in 2D again. Remember that two objects linked in this way are totally dependent. So if you move or edit the extrude object, this will affect also the 2D one inside and vice versa. You can then modify the aspect of the 3D object, changing the settings of the extrude object through the attributes panel. You can do this between normal objects as well. For example, if you want to edit or move them always together. The second way is to distort objects, and these tools are represented in a darker blue color. The process is the same, but mind that this does not create a new object, so it must be placed inside an existing object. These distortion tools work fine with both 2D and 3D objects, and can be fully edited using the attributes panel or the orange points as you did when scaling objects. Try them out. What if you need to create a custom shape? Start with an object already made and then click on Make Editable, the first icon on the left. In short, this tool transforms a ready-made model into an object that can change shape. These objects are indicated through a sort of blue triangle in the Objects panel. Then you can use the Points mode, the Edges mode, and the Polygons mode to move points, edges, and faces of the related object. For the edges and the faces, select first what to move and then edit the shape. If this is not enough, simply right-click to have the full list of actions you can do to edit the shape. Experience will teach you the right ones to be used while building your shape. Just remember to activate Live Selection if you want to exit from the current tool. Let's save our project. Go to File and then to Save As. Cinema 4D project files are saved as .c4d, used in case you want to come back editing your work. If you want to export your final work instead, go to File and then to Export, choosing the kind of file. Remember that what is exported is what is shown in the View panel at the moment. So set the object's position and the camera. Before exporting, you may want to see a final preview of your work. Simply click on Rendered View on top. You can exit clicking on the View panel. You can see just the objects and a total black background. In fact, you need to add floor, sky and light totally on your own, using the last three icons you have on top. Try them. You can manage fully the settings and the kind of the render. Choose the kind through the second icon. Choose the settings like resolution and quality using the third one. At this point, you should be able to create your first projects. This is just a startup, of course. With Cinema, you can also create projects that do change in time, using the timeline and the keyframes below. This is all. Check our channel to get more skills. Thanks for watching.